you're now reading it. I know you put out a number of statements, but I think we should address it head on. What do you make of these allegations?
Well, Sean, first let me say this. These allegations are completely false and misleading. But more than that, it hurts me personally because, you know, I'm a father. I have one daughter. I have five granddaughters, and I have a special concern for protection of young ladies. This is really hard to get on radio and explain this, and as these allegations are just completely false.
What do you make specifically? Let's start with what they talked about, that you had struck up a conversation with this young woman who was 14, Lee Kaufman, and her mother says that you offered to watch the girl while the mother went inside for a custody hearing, which they confirmed it actually happened at that time. Do you know Ms. Kaufman? Do you know the mother?
I don't know Ms. Kaufman from anybody. I've never talked to her. I never had any contact with her. Allegations of sexual misconduct with her are completely false. I believe they're politically motivated. I believe they're brought only to stop a very successful campaign, and that's what they're doing. I've never known this woman or anything with regard to the other girls. You understand this is 40 years ago, and after my return from the military, I dated a lot of young ladies. I do recognize, however, the names of two of these young ladies, Debbie Wesson and Gloria Thacker, which they have a maiden, that's their maiden name.
Well, let me just give the details. Debbie Wesson Gibson says she was 17 when you spoke to her high school civics class and asked her out on several dates, and it did not progress, her words, beyond kissing, according to the Washington Post. Let's stay on her. Did that happen?
I do not remember speaking to a civics class. I don't remember that. I do not remember when I seem to remember knowing her parents. I can remember that they were friends. I can't recall specific dates because that's been 40 years, but I remember, her as a good girl. But neither of them have ever stated any, inappropriate behavior. She didn't say anything that,
But do you remember ever going on a date with her? She said that you asked her out on the first of several dates, but nothing progressed beyond kissing.
I don't remember specific dates. No, I do not. And I don't remember if it was that time or later, but I do not remember that. No.
But you know her, but you never dated her ever. Is that what you're saying?
Know her, but I don't remember going out on dates. I knew her as a friend. If we did go out on dates, then we did, but I do not remember that.
What about Gloria Thacker Deason? Says she was an 18-year-old cheerleader when you began taking her on dates that included bottles of Matus Rosé wine. She's 18 at the time. The Alabama drinking age at the time is 19. Did that ever happen?
No, because in this county, it's a dry county. We never would have had liquor if I would never, and believe this, she said that she believed she was underage, and she, as I recall, she was 19 or older, and that just never happened. I never provided alcohol, beer, or intoxicating liquors to a minor. That'd be against the law, against anything I would ever done. And I seem to remember her as a good girl. I seem to remember that I had some sort of knowledge of her parents or her mother.
At that time in your life, let me ask you this. You do remember these girls. Would it be unusual for you as a 32-year-old guy to have dated a woman as young as 17? That would be a, 15-year difference, or a girl 18. Do you remember dating girls that young at that time?
Not generally, no. You know, I'm not going to dispute anything, but I don't remember anything like that.
But you don't specifically remember having any girlfriend that was in her late teens even at that time?
No, I don't remember that, and I don't remember ever dating any girl without the permission of her mother. And I think in her statement, she said that her mother actually encouraged her to go out with me.
Well, actually, there was one, a 14-year-old that was working as a Santa helper when you approached her, and when she was 16, and her mother forbade her. That was the third case. Let me go back to Kaufman for a minute here, because this is the issue here. She gives specific instances where the first that you met her at the courthouse, you got her phone number, you talked to her on the on the phone, and on that you drove her 30 minutes from her house to the woods and where you lived, and you kissed her, and on a second visit, you took off her shirt, pants, removed your clothes, touched her bra, underpants, and you guided her hand to touch him over your underwear. Now, those are specific charges she's making. And I think, you know, obviously it's about a month away from this election campaign.
Yeah.
Are you staying? Is it your position? None of that ever happened.
It never happened, and I don't even like hearing it because it never happened. And they're doing this a month away, 4 weeks away, after 40 years in public service. I've run five campaigns, statewide campaigns, three in the county. This has never been brought up. It has never been even mentioned. And all of a sudden, 4 weeks out, they're bringing it up. They're bringing it up because it's political. It's a direct attack on this campaign, and it involves a 14-year-old girl, which I would have never had any contact with, nothing with her mother or in a courthouse or anywhere else would I have done that. In fact, her allegations contradict the whole behavior pattern that the two of the young ladies even witnessed herself.
You mentioned you'd never go out with any young girl. I assume you meant like when you were 32 at that time of your life, would you always ask the permission of the parent before you would take a girl out?
Well, I mean, I'm saying that in their statements that they made, these two young girls said their mothers actually encouraged them to be friends with me. And, you know, that's what they said. I don't remember. I wasn't privy to their conversation, but obviously we never had any sexual activity. There was never anything like that, and the behavior was altogether appropriate, according to them.
I got to take a break. We'll come back more with Judge.